Showing up. We know you got a lot of choices tonight, and we really appreciate you finding us. Who was here last year for Nail Fest 1? Great, bunched up front. See, you guys know how good this is going to be. Well, I'm going to get off stage and bring up just a whole ton of people that have worked really hard to put a bunch of great Neil Young stuff together. Start off with a couple of friends of mine who are really at the center of this singer-songwriter scene in San Diego. We're trying to do something here, and I think at the heart of it all is the Troubadour, this monthly publication about the alt country, gospel, bluegrass, folk, singer songwriter scene. Co-founders, editors, publishers, distributors, managers, and writers, and everything. And these two people, please say hello to Ken Johnson, Liz Abbott.
One of Neil Young's favorite songwriters, I know a lot of the Canadian people, was Ian Tyson. Ian Tyson kind of led the folk scene out of Canada there back in the early 60s. And he wrote a couple songs that Neil Young recorded, Four Strong Winds, of course, as Ian Tyson. And this is one that Neil didn't record, but he used to sing in concert a little bit, called Song for Canada. Do I have some? Is that coming through there?
Talked with some old friends for a while before I
gone, I can hardly maintain.
Doesn't mean that much to me, doesn't mean that much to you. tune before I took it out of the gig bag.
Sailing hardships are broken harbors out on the waves and the night. Still the searcher must ride the dark horse racing along in his flight. Tell me why. Tell me why. Tell me why. Tell me why. Is it hard to make arrangements with yourself when you're old enough to repay but young enough to sell?
I used to know it.
Tell me lies later, come and see me, I'll be around for a while. I am lonely, but you can free me, all in the way that you smile. Tell me why. Tell me why.
Started playing guitar my junior year in high school. That was in 1973, when these songs were still really new and real fresh. What's funny about the songs is that I've aged considerably and the songs are still new and fresh. That's why we're here, right? Because new stuff is kind of pretty much timeless. And I'm glad to be here. Thanks, people. Figured out why Neil has all these guitars, so that he doesn't have to retune every time. Like Old Man's in Standard, Tell Me Why is a step down, and this is an open C. So, you know, hand me the 45, you know, and then you got it. But one guitar, that's the word. This is another one off Gold Rush, and it's Don't Let It Bring You Down. Neil's diatribe against the Queen's England, I guess. Bet he doesn't like tuning either. Thank you.
Jim Earp is an amazing fingerstyle guitarist, instrumentalist, singer-songwriter. I think he's sold more CDs than all the rest of us put together, probably, but that's just because he's great. You know, what are you gonna do? So it's a real treat to see him here. And this next guy, standing next to me here, is one of my favorite singer-songwriters in town, or anywhere. So, Derek, usually the first thing you read about him in the press or hear about him is, oh, he's so young. I really don't think about that anymore. He just writes great songs and he makes great records, and it's a pleasure to know him. Derek Duplessis.
Lashes are complicated. Okay. This next song I'm going to do is another one that, actually one of the first songs I ever learned, is Heart of Gold. And a song that I love and hopefully can pull off tonight. Okay, thank you so much for listening. This is actually my last song. I was supposed to have like three, but I never got back to Peter and I never figured out a third one, so. So thank you guys so much.
So how'd that harmonica caller work out for you?
Pretty good. Yeah.
right, guys. Now we're gonna get all crazy. Electric guitars and stuff. Thanks, Derek, for a wonderful set. That's how I met. Yeah, isn't he great? Yeah. Overcame a lot of stuff, forgetting his stuff and all that stuff. That's good. We artists really suffer, you know, for our craft. That's how I met this friend of mine sitting back here on drums. That's Danny Kress. He plays for a bunch of people. Say hi to Danny. Yeah, come on. We're just gonna chain him back there for the rest of the night, pretty much. So anyway, we've had a wonderful time in my band, The Coyote Problem, with Marsha and Danny, making a record, and the guy that helped us do that is standing right here. Not only is he a great producer, but he writes great songs, makes some tremendous records himself, and he's got some Neil Young for you tonight, Sven Erik Seaholm.
Thank you. Marsha Claire, Jenny Preston, the lovely Peter Bowman. Tell the story, 'cause I love the man. Know that some of you don't understand. Milk blood to keep from running out. Sylvia. He is a hell of a guitar player and one wonderful singer and songwriter of his own by himself. And of course, my lovely friend and partner in crimes unknown, Catherine Beat. Thank you. what we've got, but I just like to play for the fun we had.
Hey, my Sleep.
Catherine Beeks and Matt Sylvia. Love them. Well, all right, people, I want to tell you a couple of things. I got to tell you about Jeff Morgan. Have you noticed this painting hanging up here?
Yeah.
It was painted this morning. It's barely dry. That's why we put it under these heat lights tonight. So Jeff Morgan is here tonight, and he wants you to know that you can take that home with you. It's for sale. I think it's amazing. It's if you can find him, he's in this room. You know, isn't it? It's really amazing. And so he's doing well. Good day's work, as he put it. Thanks for coming back. Thanks for sticking around. We got another whole an hour and a half maybe to go. We got my little band called the Coyote Problem. We got Berkeley Hart, Jeff Berkeley, Calvin Hart, of course. Lisa Sanders is here with CJ Hutchins. And I'm forgetting somebody that I can't go. Oh, yeah. Oh, God. The mere mention of his name, I start to kind of tremble at his greatness. I'll tell you more about him later. But when I was thinking about this show, this show kind of came out of a bunch of people like us, singer-songwriters, talking about who we grew up listening to. And me and Jim Earp have been firing some emails back and forth about how we kind of cut our first chops on these songs when we were kids. So it just seemed like a natural thing to get singer-songwriters together, not to play our own stuff for once. We tend not to get this many people in the room when we do that. I have to figure that out. Oh yeah, get famous. That's right. So I thought it'd just be fun, just from a really kind of egotistic point of view, to just play stuff that we love. And then it's so gratifying to see that you guys want to come here too. So thanks a lot for coming out to Neil Fest 2. And for those of you that are just discovering Dizzy's, you've stumbled into one of the great treasures of San Diego, one of the best listening rooms in any city that a lot of us have been to. It's really wonderful. And I want you to put your hands together for a good friend of mine, John Ketcher.
Thank you. Thanks so much. If it would be at all possible to get a little more on my guitar. I was very reluctant to do this because I don't really know any Neil Young songs. But Peter brought his entire collection over to my house a couple weeks ago, so I've been frantically trying to learn these songs. If I stumble on the lyrics, maybe you guys can help me out. I think I picked three songs nobody's ever heard, though. Called The Unknown Hero. I don't even know the title. It's called Unknown Legend. Messing up already.
Chrome and steel.
she rides, colliding with the very air she breathes. The air she breathes.
Know it ain't easy, you've got to hold on. She was an unknown legend in her time. Now she's dressing two kids, waiting for a magic kiss. She gets the faraway look in her eyes. Somewhere on a desert highway, she rides a Harley Davidson. Her long blonde hair flying in the wind. She's been waiting half her life. The chrome and steel she rides, colliding with the very air she breathes. Air she breathes. We're on a desert highway. She rides a Harley Davidson. Her long blonde hair flying in the wind. She's been running half her life. The chrome and steel she rides, colliding with the very air she breathes. The air she breathes.
You guys know Thrasher? The song Thrasher? Somebody? Please? Okay. This has a lot of words.
They were hiding behind hay bales. They were planting in the full wheat. They had given all they had for something new. But the daylight was upon them. They could see those thrashers coming, and the water shone like diamonds in the dew. And I was just getting up, catch the road before it's light, trying to get an hour on the sun. When I saw those thrashers rolling by, looking more than two lanes wide, I was feeling like my day had just begun. Where the eagle glides ascending, there's an ancient river bending down the timeless gorge of changes, where sleeplessness awaits. I searched out my companions who were lost in crystal canyons as the aimless blade of science slashed the pearly gates. It was then I knew I'd had enough, burned my credit card for fuel, headed out to where the pavement turns to sand. One-way ticket to the land of truth, and my suitcase in my hands. How I lost my friends, I still don't understand. They were poisoned by protection. There was nothing that they needed, and nothing left to find. They were lost in rock formations, or became park bench mutations. On the sidewalks and in the stations, they were waiting. Waiting. So I got bored and left them there. They were just dead weight to me. Better down the road without that load. Brings me back to the time when I was 8 or 9. I was watching my mama's TV. It was that great Grand Canyon rescue episode. Where the vulture glides descending on an asphalt highway bending through libraries and museums, galaxies and stars, down the windy halls of friendship to the rose clipped by the bullwhip, the motel of lost companions waits with heated pool and bar. Me, I'm not stopping there. Got my own row left to hoe. Just another line in the field of time. When the thrashers come, I'll be stuck in the sun like the dinosaurs in shrines. But I'll know the time has come to give what's mine. Called me up yesterday and asked if I would play this song because nobody was playing it, and so I learned this today. Please help me out on this one.
dreamed I saw the, well, I dreamed I saw the knights in armor come, saying something about a dream. There were peasants singing and drummers drumming, and the archer split the tree. There was a fanfare blowing to the sun that was floating on the breeze. Look at Mother Nature on the run in the 1970s. Look at Mother Nature on the run in the 1970s. I was lugging in a burned out basement with the full moon in my eye. I was hoping for a replacement when the sun burst through the sky. There was a band playing in my head, and I felt like getting high. I was thinking about what a friend had said. I was hoping it was a lie. I was thinking about what a friend had said. I was hoping it was a lie. Dreamed I saw the silver spaceships fly through the yellow haze of the sun. There were children crying and colors flying all around the chosen ones. All in a dream, all in a dream, the loading had begun. They were flying Mother Nature's silver seat to a new home in the sun. They were flying Mother Nature's silver seat to a new home.
John Ketcher.
I wished I didn't know my songs quite as well as John doesn't know his.
All right, you guys. We got CJ Hutchins on guitar and my good friend Lisa Sanders. Please say hello.
Hello.
Jeff, just play a teeny bit more guitar, please.
Neil Young was like the first song I ever learned how to play was like Helpless. And when it came out, so that being said, I asked CJ to play it tonight. All these amazing guitar players in here, a girl's got to take advantage.
Over how she set me free. Thank you.
Lisa Sanders wasn't here for Bruce Fest a few weeks ago when we did that. We almost got her, but she had to go off and do something else. So we're so glad she could make it tonight. Can we hear it again for Lisa Sanders? I remember some years ago, a good friend of mine, Steve, and I went down to the old Java Joe's two moves ago, the one on Newport, to see this guy here, and the whole room was packed. And one of the things he did that night was he went around before the show and just talked to everybody in the room. He just walked up to people and he shook their hands and he said hello, and I thought that was really a nice thing, and I never do that, but I thought that was really, I'd like to say I learned from him, but I didn't. But that show was amazing. I sat on the edge of my seat and I decided to get a little more serious about what I was doing. Just an amazing guy, Gregory Page.
Thank you, Peter. I remember that evening because the dorm person didn't show up, so I was going around just getting money. Let's hear it for Peter Bolin, everybody. He does such a great job putting this together. It's not easy. It's quite an accomplishment getting all of these performers together in the same room. We don't even like each other, you know? So it's really amazing. From down
carry home. My friends are scattered like leaves from an old maple. Some are weak, some are strong. One of these days, I'm gonna sit down and write a long letter to all the good friends I've known. One of these days.
Singers in the group named Frank Lee Drennan, who's currently playing this evening in Dublin, does a version of this song called Albuquerque that just breaks my heart every time I hear it, and so I'm going to try to do it some sort of justice. The song is called Albuquerque.
I've been flying down the road.
find some fried eggs, a country ham. I'll go somewhere. They don't care who I am. Oh, Albuquerque. Funny hearing that next door, you know? The buildings are right next to each other, but we could not be any more far apart. Couldn't we be any further than the motherfuckers? C.J. Hutchins, can you help me with this song, please? I've been off the pot now for 3 years. Off the pot. I actually don't know why. I forgot to smoke. I think this song has some references to it. So. Thank you. Well, while we were playing Harvest and thinking I was playing Roll Another Number, I looked over at UCJ and I thought, why are you singing the wrong chorus? I was all ready to point the blame. I'm a million miles away from today. Oh, I don't believe I'm coming that way.
That's right, after a great art like that, it should be a hushed, museum-like vibe. That's what we want. Well, we got a few more surprises with you, for you, and with you. Although that was pretty surprising. Yeah. We got a little surprise guest tonight. You guys might know him, Jose Sinatra.
Don't stand, please. Thank you. Don't stand up, man. Because it's not about me tonight. It's about someone very special to us all. Neil. Neil Young. Those words mean so much to each and every one of us. He's probably my closest friend in the entertainment business. I called him this morning and left a message asking him to come here tonight. I told him 2 minutes ago. So, if he came, Neil, come on up. Okay, when I think about Neil, though, it's like not what he means to me, it's like how much I mean to him. And his whole family, his sister, the actress Sean, his brothers, Angus and Mighty Joe, and the whole Young family permeates my own life, I'm sure, as it does yours. If I can touch just one of you deeply with what I'm about to sing, then you're an idiot.
Thank you. destiny. We were looking at all the clouds. There were plants and birds and rocks and things, but Oz never did give nothing to the Tin Man. That he didn't. After wee wee.
He put me up to that. That's Jose Sinatra. So we get to play a song now, I guess. It's all just a big ruse so we could get all you people here so we get to play our three songs.
I got Tin Man stuck in my head now. Bolan's band, we're the Coyote Problem.
I'm thinking of she.
Yeah, we're called the Coyote Problem. We're giving away stickers. Anybody here who wants a sticker, there's a bunch of them piled up over there. It's really fun to put them on police cars. I don't know, just an idea. If you wanted a little excitement tonight. Yeah, so. A bunch of us are selling CDs tonight. I know I've seen Lisa's over there. I know Gregory's got some. We have some of ours. So if you'd like to get a CD of any of our stuff, no Neil Young songs on any of them, probably.
Probably.
I don't know. But isn't there a little Neil inside of all of us? Pretty good, huh? How I work that out. This song's called I Believe in You. Our buddy Jeff Berkeley. You guys know Jeff? We love Jeff. Come on, Jeff, get up here and tell a joke. No, that's all right. We'll cover you.
You go for it. I'll be right with you.
I could launch into the exciting sign our mailing list talk. No. There's some confusion about Neil's politics. There's a certain amount of obvious environmentalism and left-leaning politics with Greendale. You go back into the 80s and you find this strange period where he's a Ronald Reagan supporter. And I just love that you can't really pin this guy down. And rather than being an ideologue, he's just another confused Canadian. Wondering, what is it with these Americans? So this is a war song, and I don't know what it's about. It's called Powderfinger. Look out, Mama, there's a white boat coming up the river with a big red beacon and a flag and a man on the rail. I think you better call John, cause it's don't look like you're here to live now. And I'm missing my way. I hope they didn't come to stay. It's got numbers on the side and a good. Thank you.
Is okay? Yeah. How about the coyote problem? Great band. This has been an awesome show. You guys are so polite. I'm always afraid. This amplifier is made by Sears in 1959. And sometimes that was a good year for Sears amps. Sometimes I get shocked pretty bad. Thank you.
to make it today.
Always so fun. We gonna use these, I think, just in case. This is it's funny that Peter came to me. He goes, he wanted me to do this song, Harvest Moon. I didn't know that. He called me up. He goes, "Hey Jeff, can you sing really high?" I said, "Sure,
always, always."
But I misunderstood. Try to get up to this one. That Neil's got a hell of a range.
Just like children's
voice on this one. You know it.
Because I'm still in love with you. I wanna see you dance again. Because I'm still in love with you. My heart is hard as blue.
Thank you all so much. Once again, please, for the Coyote Problem, what an amazing band. Folks who went out and voted. We were going to do this song that Buffalo Springfield recorded called Mr. Soul. And then all of a sudden I looked at the list or somebody told me, I think Peter told me, you know, nobody's doing Ohio.
I said, what?
Soldiers and Nixon's coming, we're finally on our own. This summer I hear the drumming for dead and all my own. Gotta get down to it, soldiers are gunning us down. Should've been done long ago. What if you knew? Thank you.
Berkeley Harbor from San Diego, California. Come out and see us sometime. We got CDs. Let's hear it for Peter Boland and the Coyote Problem. That's Berkeley Hard, everybody. Our families. We love Berkeley Hard.
We have one more musical offering for you tonight. Let us get set up for that. It's because of Derek Duplessis that I got to meet Danny Kress, and it was through another friend of mine, Donald Choa, that I got to meet Marsha and another band. I got an email the other day from someone who saw our band at the Adams Avenue Street Fair, and she was talking about, how do you get into a band? How do you meet people? You know, these ads and the Raiders and all that kind of, you know, people coming over to your house, you don't know who they are. All I could tell her was, you just have to start playing a lot of shows by yourself with whoever you can find and just get into rooms like this. And I mean, it's been a great gift working in this scene these last 10 years and meeting all these amazing people. So they actually gave me their phone numbers so I could call them and ask them to come do this show with us. So one of the greatest partners in this whole music world that I've run across, her voice, her bass playing on our other record Frame and on the record that's coming out. It's been a real joy working with Marsha. This is Marsha Clare.
Lisa and Catherine are gonna sing, "Look at All the Women." And then all the women were on stage. Tonight the stage, tomorrow the world. It's a secret, don't tell. It's a secret. Unlike most of Neil Young's songs, this one doesn't have a dead guy in it, or a dead girl. Nobody dies. There is, however, sadness. Thank you so much, everybody, for coming out. This is just really a treat. Awesome mind. What an awesome lineup. And got to see some people that I've never had a chance to see live, which is John Ketcher. See, I said, let's bring John Ketcher on. Who? Put him on the spot. So, loved it. And he actually wanted to do this song. And I'm like, oh. Thanks, everybody, for coming.
We all
out.
Did.
Yeah.
Feathers fall around.
Marcia Claire, everybody. Thank you so much. See you November 12th next year. Thanks for coming out.